Here is the preliminary horizontal alignment along Cohasset Ridge that we have created. There are many ways to edit this alignment if we wish to do so. First, we can click on the alignment, and grabbing the grips, we can adjust the alignments. You can see here how the curve adjusts. The editing is limited by Civil 3D because curves cannot be allowed to overlap. The point of tangent on this curve cannot be beyond the point of curve on the next. Civil 3D recognizes when this happens and will not allow the editing. And now we are done editing using the grips, so we can just press the escape button to release the grips. To access other ways of editing the alignment, click on the alignment. Right-click. And this flyout menu provides options for editing the alignment. For example, we can edit alignment geometry. Selecting Edit Alignment Geometry brings up the Alignment Layout toolbar again. Let's select the Alignment Grid View. The window that opens contains all of the geometric information from our horizontal alignment at this time. We can also edit the alignment from this window. Let's say we want to change the radius of this curve from 5,000 to 4,000. We can do this by entering the new radius in this box. Press Enter, and it will adjust the radius of that curve. Let's close this and explore another option. We'll close the alignment toolbar as well. Let's look at some of the other options on our flyout menu that we can access by selecting the alignment and right-clicking. We'll look at alignment properties. The information tab contains that basic information that we typed just before we created the horizontal alignment. We can also edit this information here if we need to. The Station Control tab contains information about the stationing. We can also access general information about the constraints, checks, and design criteria. Hit Cancel to leave this menu. Right-click again. We just looked at Edit Alignment Properties. Let's look at Edit Alignment Style next. We have general information. This is a proposed alignment. Under design, we can change the grip edit behavior. Marks and display. It's generally good to check out the display tab because it shows what layers are part of this alignment. So from here we can control the layers without having to go to the layer manager and fish through all the long list of layers that are part of the project. We are also provided a summary of the information and settings that we have chosen up to this point. Let's just cancel this. We'll select the alignment and right-click to access the flyout menu. Remember, the Edit Alignment Geometry is how we pulled up the Horizontal Alignment toolbar. Right now, we'll select Edit Alignment Labels. This is where all the labeling information is, and also where we changed the increment at which the stations were being identified. So we can edit this at any time. Over here, under Geometry Points, we can control which points are labeled. If we do not want the midpoint of the curve to appear, this is where we can go to remove it. Over here under Geometry Points, we can click on the triple dot button. Here's a list of all the points that will be labeled. We can remove the curve midpoint label by unchecking its box. The rest of the settings are okay, so we can press OK to accept the change. And right now we can see that the midpoints are still labeled. But as soon as we hit the apply, they go away. Now that we know the midpoint labels were removed, we can press OK to leave the alignment labels window. Let's pan over to the beginning of the project. Here we have a lot of labels and the clarity suffers. We want to clear this up, so we'll select the alignment and right-click again. Again, let's go to Edit Alignment Labels. And here we can see among our alignment labels we have a design speed. This is not necessary, so we can select it and click the red X to take it out. Again, we notice that the label remains until we hit apply. Let's say we realize that we need to put the design speed label back in. The types of labels are listed in this combo box. So we can click the design speed. Hit add, and it's placed back on the list. Hit apply. And the design speed is labeled on the alignment again. Let's just remove the design speed one more time. Apply. Many other things that are labeled here are things we'll need as we move through the project. Another consideration is the label style. Perhaps the way the stationing is being labeled here requires some editing. Let's say we want to edit the major stations. We can go in and click on the little tag-looking symbol and pull up the Pick Label Styles box. For example, let's see how the option to set the labels perpendicular with the tick looks rather than parallel with the tick. Press OK. Right now we can see that the stationing is unchanged. Hit apply and the labels are flipped so that they are perpendicular with the tick. This may be more desirable. Returning to the Pick Label Style box, let's say we want to edit the labeling itself. We'll keep the perpendicular with ticks in the combo box and open this dialog box. We have the option to edit the current selection. Click that. This opens another window from which we can edit how the labels are being presented. For example, we could change the height of the text, the angle of rotation, or many other settings. It is generally best not to change these too dramatically. The most common change is the text height. Remember that the text height designated here is the height at which it will be plotted, and not how it will show up on screen. We can see some of the other settings available here. You can experiment with some of these other settings, but it is smart to jot down or copy the original dialog box before you change things too much. That way you know what the original settings were and can return to them if your alterations are not turning out the way you'd hoped. Let's just cancel out of here. Hit OK. So now we have seen that there are many ways of working with text here. Let's say OK. One of the things we want to avoid is trying to edit these labels as you would in AutoCAD. Let's press Escape to release the grips. We can see here that the beginning of the alignment is still crowded. It has the stationing for the beginning of the alignment plus the stationing for the beginning of the project overlapping. We can select that label and drag it. To do this, we'll click on this grip and drag it down, placing the label all the way out here. We use a leader. Click and press Escape. I bet we have the same problem over at the end of the project, so we can go back over there and edit that as well. In review, we have used the flyout menu accessed by clicking on the alignment and then right-clicking. We've looked at the alignment properties, editing alignment styles, editing alignment geometry, which is how we can bring up the alignment layout toolbar. And we also looked at editing alignment labels. Let's save these settings.